Today, I am trying out the Arc browser for the first time, which everyone seems to be talking about. More precisely, I have been using the browser for a week now, and I will share my 1 week experience where I find necessary. If you like this kind of videos, please take a moment to subscribe to the channel and like this video. Before we start, I should mention that this browser is currently only supported on macOS. For Windows users, don't run away yet because the developer has stated that it will come to Windows too. When I entered the website to download, I encountered a page like this. I'm gonna start downloading while I'm browsing through the website. Space for the different size of you. So, this is one of the selling points of this browser. You can create different spaces for your different tasks. For example, you can have work tabs in one space and entertainment tabs in another. This system looks like the focus feature on Apple devices. With a single swipe, all tabs, colors, and feelings change. Your browser, your way. This part explains what I call the IKEA effect. Let me explain. The IKEA effect is a tendency to attribute more value to products in which one has contributed to their production. In here, we see this as customizing the browser with our own color and design, making it more internalized and lovable. After that, there's Arc Max. Simply put, this feature can be described as integrated artificial intelligence into the browser. For example, you can access artificial intelligence by pressing the shortcut normally used for search on a page, or simply hover your mouse over a link to get a preview of this page. Here, it explains the automatic naming of downloads. Let me show you this feature. For example, when downloading a PDF from an email, the file has a completely meaningless name. After downloading, it corrects the file name with artificial intelligence and saves it that way. It's a truly nice feature. If you talked about the website and promised features, let's move on to browser. Well, these guys know how to welcome people. Meet the internet again. Okay, let's see. I'm not a fan of creating an account for the browser, but okay. Okay, this is cool because the biggest problem when switching from one browser to another is not transferring any data. So using this data from my old browser instead of starting from the scratch is a nice thing. So this is Arc's approach to apps. I said apps because they treat them as apps. Let me explain. Arc thinks their browser is like a hub where you can access all of your apps. You need YouTube? Here. You need Twitter? Here. But of course, there are pros and cons to this approach. As a plus, having website right at your fingertips and the idea of being able to personalize apps through the application are really nice. Another plus is that you can personalize apps through the application. See, Arc has a feature called Boost. And it has its own store called Boost Gallery. In this store, there are dozens of themes for many sites. It has extensions that completely change the appearance of Gmail, Twitter, YouTube, and it's a well-thought-of application. As if that weren't enough, you can create your own theme. As a minus, it does not open its own native applications on the computer. For example, when clicking on a tweet link, if I open it using Safari, it opens the Twitter application, but if I open it using Arc, it prefers to open the application within itself. I can say it wants to monopolize. The bad part is that in applications where the web applications is bad, like Spotify, I would prefer to use the native application. As I mentioned before, azuring community from the previous browser is a nice thing. One of the main reasons I use Safari is password saving feature. This is the customization screen I mentioned earlier. As you can see, you can choose any color you want. I will choose green. It's nice that it has its own ad blocker. I'll choose yes. The Arc Max feature I mentioned before. I will enable it. When we complete the installation, it gives a badge showing your name. IKEA effect all over the place again. They're trying to make you feel at home. So after 1 week of using Arc, here are my takes. I will basically tell you about the differences from other browsers, and in the end, is it worth the change? First of all, I like the spaces logic. Switching between profiles is fast and easy. Separating all the history, bookmarks, and various features in another profile keeps it clean. It's nice to quickly reach ChatGPT when opening a new tab. Although it may be not a common usage scenario for standard users, it's a nice feature for developers and creators. Another distinctive feature is artificial intelligence creating summaries for you before you entering sites. Although it's not a groundbreaking feature, I prefer AI to quickly pick at a site rather than spending a long time looking at it. One of my favorite features is automatically naming downloads. I gave the example of a PDF earlier. So the final question is it worth the change? Look, I'm not a programmer or a professional content creator. I'm a normal user. Using the designs and artificial intelligence capabilities offered by Arc has made my work easier. On top of that, I enjoy using a browser that I have customized myself. So the answer is yes. I can definitely recommend you to use this browser. Before finishing the video, I just want to say I spent so much time editing in this video. So a like and a subscribe would be very nice. Also, you can click on the card to watch the video where I talk about spending a month with my iPhone 6 to reduce my screen time.